I'm Suzanne Spine with Atlas RFID, and we are at RFID Journal Live 2014 at the Zebra booth. And we are here with Adebayo. How are you doing today?
Very well, thank you.
Good. So you're going to be good taking us through Zatar, which uses the Internet of Things to link devices. Is that correct?
Yeah.
So can you tell us a little bit more about Internet of Things? What are we talking about here?
Okay, so first, today is actually the Internet of Things Day, 9th of April. So,
oh, we heard that actually, yeah.
So happy Internet of Things Day. And so what we're doing at Zebra is the Internet of Things is a principle where all devices will actually be able to communicate, right? So they can literally go into the cloud and enable themselves to be seen and allow other applications to actually access that device. We believe for that to be possible because there's potentially, 50 billion plus devices that are going to get connected. You need a platform that's going to make that scalable and really easy for people to add those devices and then create the scenario where they can share that information. So you can either make a device private, public, or shared among your groups. So what we're showing today as a printer company is actually adding one of our new Zebra ZD500 printers into Zatar. Okay, and that is a graphic illustration of what Zatar looks like. Again, we like to think of it as a Facebook for devices. So each device actually has its own profile page. You can see information about that device. You can see its location. And you actually have an activity stream. You'll also be able to see the location and whatever's going on with the printer. So in this scenario, this device will be considered an IoT device.
Okay.
It's connected into Zatar and will have an open API for people to write applications to actually access it. Traditionally, if you had to talk to a Zebra printer, you'd send a ZPL command. In the Zatar world, you don't have to understand what language that printer speaks.
Okay.
You just write your own application in whatever language you like and send it through Zatar, and then Zatar sends the right ZPL language to that printer.
So it just decodes what you're saying.
Correct.
And encodes it in the way that the printer knows what
Absolutely.
It's talking about.
Absolutely.
Awesome. Okay, so you have all different devices on there right now.
Yeah, so the other application that we're showing is, this is an example of what is called Bluetooth Low Energy Beacon Technologies. And in this particular scenario, what we're doing is, there's a mobile phone app that we just developed just to test this. And this app will allow you to actually detect the beacon. Okay, so BLE signals basically just shoot out their BLE signals and send an hexadecimal number. So my app will now say, okay, I want to detect that beacon. And once it detects the beacon, it pushes that information into Zatar. And that updates my account saying, oh, Bio is close to this beacon. And then in that particular instance, what we have is we have a display screen that is looking into Zatar and saying, tell me everybody close to me. And based on that, it publishes my name onto the screen. So again, Zatar all of a sudden has been able to connect two separate independent systems. A beacon technology that knows nothing about this screen, and a screen that knows nothing about the beacon technology. And they don't have to understand what languages they speak to themselves. They just look into Zatar, and Zatar makes that translation possible.
Well, great. Thank you so much for taking us through there. Any last words about Zatar, about what it does? Anything you want to tell our viewers?
No, I mean, we just think, you know, RFID is going to be a key component for IoT. We think a lot of devices are going to rely on barcode technology and RFID as underlying components to how they get connected. And that's kind of why we're here at this show. You know, we're building our ecosystem of partners that get their devices supported onto Zatar, so end user customers can immediately drive value from some of those technologies.
Okay, great. Well, thank you so much. We enjoyed the booth so much and the Zatar part of it. It's really awesome what you're doing with the Internet of Things.
Thank you very much.
Happy Internet of Things Day. Thank you for letting us know. Well, I hope you have a great end of RFID Journal Live. I know we're kind of coming to a close on the second day.
Yep.
So have a great day and we'll see you later.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.